Hi, I'm Jack Dugas with Rogers Security, providing services in the Southern Ontario area for the last 30 years. We've partnered here today with Pipl Systems to bring you some of the fun facts and features of this new AI-powered doorbell from Ajax Systems. We're going to walk you through some of the scenarios that it involves and how it can be integrated into the whole ecosystem for not just your home, but also for your business. Because this doorbell is going to be integrated into a larger Ajax ecosystem, we've already previously installed a Hub 2 Plus, as well as an Ajax 8-channel NVR, which we'll also integrate some cameras into later as well. Essentially, what we're going to run through here is a little bit of installation. So inside the box, you'll see it comes with not only the unit itself, but it comes with two different angled brackets. Depending on what your orientation of your door is, you can either do a tilt or a left to right. As well as there's a couple of terminal wires and what's called a bell kit, which integrates your original mechanical door chime to function with the Ajax doorbell. So the doorbell is going to replace a Ring doorbell in this exact same location and utilizing the same power cables that would be utilized either from a previous video doorbell or also from a mechanical doorbell originally. So we can reuse the wiring, don't have to run any extra cables. Essentially, what's going to happen is you're going to remove your old doorbell, whether it be video or mechanical. You're then going to take the backing plate, mount that on. You have three options. You can either do the flat mount, there's a tilt mount, and then there's a side angle mount, depending on how your door is laid out. As you can see here on this one, we ended up going with the side angle mount to kind of point the camera more towards the door. Once that's complete, you'll then take the backing plate, mount that to that mounting bracket, and then attach your wires to the terminals on the back of the doorbell, tuck all of those away, snap the doorbell onto the mounting bracket, and then put in the safety screw in the bottom. So now the next step after the installation would be programming and adding the doorbell to your hub. So what you want to do is you're going to want to dismount the doorbell from the bracket. On the back, you'll see a QR code. You're going to want to go into your app, go under Add Devices. You're going to want to scan that QR code. Once that happens, it's gonna ask you to power on the device. On the back of the doorbell, there's a power button. Press and hold for about 3 seconds. You'll see it start flashing. It'll turn on. At that point, follow through the app. It'll give you step-by-step instructions about how to connect to Bluetooth and then Wi-Fi. Other than that, there's a few customizationable steps that we can take, which we'll discuss later. This has been our standard practice for the last 100, 110, doorbells, systems, all of that stuff that we've installed through Ajax so far. We haven't had many issues with integration and installation as far as any of this goes, but we'd like to run through everything with you anyways. So inside the Ajax doorbell, there's a few different settings that you can change in regards to notifications and how the device works. Firstly, you can create a name for it, which is called a doorbell typically. Recording preferences, if you have an NVR included with your system, you can set it to there. If not, there is also cloud-based storage as well available on the side. Notifications from the cameras, you can see there's a few different notifications that you can get: human, pet, vehicle, and then just general motion events as it is now. So let's turn a couple of these on. And you can see that with the integrated motion sensor inside the doorbell itself, you can pick and choose whether you want to be notified only when the motion sensor detects a person as well, meaning they'd have to be a little bit closer to the doorbell rather than just someone walking by on the sidewalk. So if we turn that on, you can choose when you want to be notified. So you can be notified at all times or only when you arm your system. We usually change that to always. Notification delay intervals. We don't typically touch this, but you can set essentially, this will tell you like, if the same person is standing out front of your doorbell for 5-10 minutes or whatever, you can change the interval so that it doesn't keep dinging and dinging and dinging the guy over and over and over again. You can do this up to every 8 hours. I don't know why you would do it that long, but you can do it that way. Duration of the object is kind of the opposite of that. So someone has to be in front of your camera for 2 to 5 seconds for the notification to go through. Obviously you can turn that off and do a notify instantly. So as soon as anything comes in front of the screen, it will notify you right away. Next we have some detection settings. So you can turn on and off the integrated motion sensor. Frame analysis basically runs on the pixels in the picture itself. So what happens is when you open it up, you can see that you have some different sensitivities. You can even go in and adjust your activity zone. So what'll happen here is, if you don't want it to look at the sky, you change it to the eraser on the right hand side, and you can deselect cells, right? You can click the pencil, you can reselect specific cells. So essentially what this does is it allows you to pick and choose which areas of the camera you want notifications to come from. The other ones here, so area occupied has to do with the size of the object in the camera view, and the sensitivity has to do with how many pixels are changed in that camera view for it to set off a notification or an alarm. Object detection settings, which again you can turn on and off, runs on the same premise in the activity zone. So again, open and change the pixels, determine where you want your object detection to come from. And individually you can change between human, pet, and vehicle, your sensitivity, if you want the detection to even work. If you don't care about animals going across, you can turn off pet detection, for example. And then you can change the sensitivity threshold, where lower is less sensitive, higher is more sensitive. It kind of helps a little bit with distance as well. Next, we have the video stream in here. We don't typically touch anything because the automatic stream setup comes through pretty good. But here you can change things like resolution quality, which typically it's already at the highest, bit rates, different things like that. For some applications, you may need to change some of this, but we don't typically touch any of that stuff. Same with the image. If you really want to get technical with it, you can change all the stuff like color saturation, brightness, sharpness. If you want wide dynamic range, because that's an option available on here, you just tap that, turns that on, right? You see the screen flash. You got some switching conditions that you can do, so you can set up, like, if you want to record color, attempt to record color later in the day, or it'll auto switch to IR for night vision. You can change that here as well. As far as audio goes, enable, disable your audio here. That's from the microphone built into the doorbell. You can change the volume of the microphone. You can change the volume of the speaker, which is the speaker outside for when you're talking through to somebody at the door. You can adjust the volume on that as well. Other than that, pretty straightforward. Privacy zones. So this is essentially, say you have that neighbor that doesn't want you recording their driveway, or you have something in your front yard that you don't want people to see. Again, same sort of thing as it was with the motion capture. You get an image of the screen, you hit the little plus rectangle at the bottom, that brings up the rectangle on the screen. Adjust the size, adjust where it needs to go, and essentially all of your videos that record will always have that space blocked out. So all of your recordings, not anything that Ajax can access, not even anything that you can access, nothing will record behind that black box. Hit reset, reset it back to normal. Now, something that's kind of getting a little newer in regards to Ajax with their AI is alarm response. So you can see here that the doorbell will respond on its own as an independent alarm. The other options that we have here is it can work in tandem with your Ajax security system, your intrusion aspect of the security system. We get instant alarms, entry exits, followers, the same thing as you'll see with motion sensors, door contacts. They all have those same kind of settings and the same kind of operating features. So you can essentially use this as a pre-alarm to your door before anyone even has the ability to touch it. Arming in night mode. Obviously, when you go to night mode, when you go to bed, this will turn on, so in that way your exterior is protected while you're in your room. A couple other things, there's some chime settings. There is the digital chime, which will go through the siren if you have a security system with it as well. There's also the mechanical chime. So if you have a pre-existing doorbell with a pre-existing mechanical chime box, which is typically mounted on a wall somewhere near the front door, there is a little gray box that you can integrate into that original mechanical chime, and that way when someone presses the doorbell, it rings your doorbell like it normally would on your normal installer doorbell. You can choose to turn the siren off at all. Obviously, there's an option here for not connected. And then at that point, once you connect the hub and you do all that stuff, you can choose again to run the siren for the doorbell. A couple of other things, I guess the only other thing is with an NVR, you can integrate the storage so you don't have to pay for cloud storage. You integrate the storage into the NVR. And then yeah, you can turn on and off the LEDs. You can turn on and off the sound button press. There's a lot of different things that you can set up to make this doorbell truly your own in regards to notifications, detections, scenarios, how the doorbell acts in regards to alarm, not alarm. For more of this, you can look up their user guides, which are very easily accessed through any of their settings, through any of their devices. As you can see here, just click the one button and you're already up in the user manual. And this is the same manual that we have access to. Obviously, there's nothing hidden from you, nothing special for us to not be like withholding information, anything like that. Everything that you have, everything that we have is all available online on their website. So we're just about to demo the doorbell here, show you the clarity of the 4-megapixel camera with the wide dynamic range built into it. It's also IP65 rated for water and dust protection. 20-foot infrared capabilities for night vision. It also has two options with the door chimes, whether you have an existing door chime or you have no door chime present at the moment. You can either use the bell kit to integrate the mechanical door chime into the system, or you can use an Ajax siren to do your doorbell signaling as well. So let me press the button here. I've already got the notification on the screen. And here we'll see, once I tap that notification, it brings me directly in to the doorbell camera. From there, we can press the button to talk through the camera. Hello?
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 You can see it's very fast,
very
clear, and works almost seamlessly from the phone. So the last thing we're going to talk about, some of the features and functionalities of the Ajax doorbell. One of the main benefits is the AI detection. So the couple of things that you have are human, vehicle, pet, and also just general motion detection that comes across. You can alternate, you can choose which of these notifications you want to come up, whether you want all of them, none of them, one of them, it's up to you. We're going to test here to show you just how quickly the doorbell notifies you once it detects a person. So once I turn around this corner, the doorbell is going to see me. It's going to send a notification directly to my phone. So now we're in front of the doorbell camera. And as you can see, we got the notification come through. If we tap on the notification, it brings us right up to our notification setting in the app. But what it really does is it allows you to be notified of someone approaching your doorbell, so you're prepared that once they press the button, you can access your doorbell camera right from there. So we've talked a bit about the features and functionality of the doorbell itself, but now let's get into what really matters and what you get out of it, right? So as you can see here, when I scroll across the bottom of my my scrubber bar, you can see the different colors, the different pictures, the different squares. Essentially what that's doing is that's filtering out from all of your AI events. So like I said about vehicle detection, person detection, so on. So it's all color coded. It's also at the bottom, if you see the little funnel here, you can pick and choose what you want to filter, what you want to see, and it'll only pull up the events that have to do with that specific AI filter. You can go just to doorbell button presses, so then it only shows every time that they do the doorbell as an added feature on that. And that part's only with the doorbell itself. The cameras do not have that filtering power because obviously they don't have a button. At the bottom, you have your calendar. This only has one day as we just installed it for demo, but you can reference back months at a time. You go to your specific time of day that you want to reference, hit apply, brings you right to that point there. So then what you do after the fact, if you have an incident or something of significance or importance that happens, What you can do is you can download it straight through the Ajax app right into your phone, whether it's iOS or Android. Press the three dots in the bottom right corner to bring up your menu. You'll see there's a couple of options here. You're going to want to hit download. And then what you're going to do is you're going to find your timeline, select a starting point, scroll to where you need it to end at. You're going to hit end here, request file, and you'll see there that the file has now started downloading. The other benefit that comes with this is, as you can see, you get a notification. So nobody can take these files without you knowing. Nobody can do this secretly. There's no way to get around it. Once that's completed, you see you can click the download at the top right there, brings up your little clip, hit the green button. Now it's downloading to your phone. Once that's done, it just pops right up into your Photos app. You can then from there send it in an email, a text message, whatever you need to do with it beyond that. And that will be with you until you delete it. On a note of deleting files, I just want to also mention that the cloud storage and the NVR storage, what happens with them is once those get full up, they basically delete old records and keep re-recording over new. You don't have to worry about storage getting full. You don't have to worry about manually deleting stuff that you don't need. It just automatically re-records over itself. So the last piece of kit that I want to talk about here is, you'll notice another icon at the bottom. When you're in live view, so obviously once you scrub back, you see it gets replaced by the play pause button. But when you're in live view, hypothetically, someone comes, rings your doorbell, you open up, you talk back and forth, and you allow this person to enter your premise. The little switch button in the middle at the bottom, you can press that, brings you right to the door locks, light switches, anything that has to do with home automation, which is quite a few things now with the whole Ajax ecosystem. You can tap right there from the screen, right from the doorbell. And my front door just unlocked. Get a notification about that as well, because the same thing, nobody can do anything on this without your knowledge. So in conclusion, like we mentioned, this video was mostly about the video doorbell. But Ajax themselves, you know, they cover a wide variety of needs from intrusion, video surveillance, home monitoring. We ourselves as Rogers Security have experience in not just Ajax, Honeywell DSC products, and a few others that, you know, would take a while to mention. We have not only experience in video and intrusion, but we also do card access anywhere in Southern Ontario. Find us on our website, rogers-security.com. We've been in the business for about 32 years now, family grown, family made. I've actually got the privilege of being introduced into it, as it's my father-in-law who's the CEO/owner and still has been after 32 years of running the business on his own. We're here to back him up a little bit. So I myself mostly do the sales. So if you want to drop me a line, call the office, they'll connect you with me. And yeah, we'd love to start a relationship with you. Hit us up. Peace.